Holy Spirit, touch your people now. We are praying for our brother John Disakazari in a hospital. You're the great physician. Send your healing angel, Father, to touch his body and make him whole. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Bible says in Psalm 103, I am the Lord who forgiveth all your iniquity, who healeth all your disease. The Bible says, by your stripes, my brother was already healed. So, Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray that you touch his body, Lord, that you make him whole again. Hallelujah, to be with his family. In the name of Jesus, Father, you say, when you pray, believe. The Bible said, you sent your word and you healed them. You healed your children and you set them free from destruction. So, Father, in the name of Jesus, we rebuke the devil in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and we proclaim healing, healing, healing in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We believe in the supernatural. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. In Jesus Christ's mighty name. Amen. Genesis 28, verse 10. Now Jacob went out from Beersheba and went toward Aram. You know, now Jacob is running away from his brother Esau. Genesis 28:10. He has the birthright and is running away from his brother Esau. The Bible says, hallelujah, 28:11, Genesis. So he came to a certain place and stayed there all night, because the sun had set. Amen. In other words, you need the light of the sun to walk. The Son of Man. Now he said, and he took one of the stone of that place. Amen. You know, the stone of revelation. Amen. Amen. He took one of the stone of that place and put it on his head. That's all you need. Put the stone of revelation on your head and you shall see mighty things. And he, hallelujah, lay down in that place to sleep. You may be seated. You know where Jacob was laying? He put a stone for a pillow. And that stone is Jesus Christ, the revelation, hallelujah, of this end time message. And Jacob put the stone and then he slept. The Bible says, when you sleep, you shall not be afraid of the arrow by night. Praise God. Amen. There shall 1,000 fall on your side, 10,000 on the other side. It shall never come near you. Amen.
Amen.
And then he began to sleep. Verse 12. Then he dreamed, and behold, he saw a ladder, a supernatural ladder. How many wants to see the supernatural?
Amen.
You just need to walk with God.
Amen.
You are a supernatural being yourself. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And then he saw a ladder. It was set up on the earth. How long was the ladder? Setting up on the earth and reaching to the heaven. Hallelujah. Oh, I love this. And it's reached to the heaven. And then, listen to this, the angels of God were ascending and descending upon it. Jacob saw a ladder and the angels of God were ascending.
Amen.
And descending.
Amen.
So it means the angel were here on the earth.
Amen.
The angels of God are here now.
Amen.
Now they ascend and then they descend.
Amen.
Remember Jesus talking to Nathanael when Philip brought him to Jesus. He said, can something good come from Nazareth? And Philip said, just come and see.
Amen.
We don't talk too much. We don't make a lot of noise. Just come and see. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God in human flesh. Oh, when Philip brought Nathanael and he was before Jesus, he looked at him, said, behold, a man in which there's no fraud.
Amen.
And Nathanael said, Rabbi, you are the Messiah, the King of Israel. Jesus looked at him and said, because I said, Before Philip called you, you were under the fig tree, you believed. But I tell you, you will see mighty things. You will see the Son of Man, and you will see angels ascending and descending upon the ministry of the Son of Man. And this, in this evening time, Amen. We have received the ministry, the revelation of the Son of Man.
Amen.
We must see the judge angels ascending and descending upon this ministry.
Amen.
Why are angels there? It's for a mission. It's for a purpose
Amen.
That I'm going to tell you in this study. But here Jacob sees a ladder with angels. This is a supernatural ladder. Amen.
Amen.
This morning, I want to talk about the ministry of angels. Hallelujah. Let's keep reading. So angels of God ascending and descending. Amen. If you are tired this morning, if you are sick this morning, if you have problem this morning, if you are weary this morning, there's angels of God.
Amen.
They have a commission to take you, to lift you up to the throne of grace,
Amen.
The throne of mercy. And when they bring you down, you are supernatural charged with the power of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Oh, somebody shout.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. He said, and behold, the Lord stood above it and said, so on top of the ladder was God himself standing there, and he said, I am the Lord God of Abraham, your father, and the God of Isaac. Is Abraham your father?
Amen.
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 And the land on which you lie, I will give it to your descendant. Praise God. So I want to talk about the ministry of angels. Now we were talking about the throne. Amen?
Amen.
Now watch this. If you look at the throne, we were telling you about the throne in the heaven. Amen? Where Jesus, the corporal body of Jesus, sit there to make intercession because it's the mercy seat. Now if you look here in the tabernacle that Moses built in the wilderness, Moses went up to heaven, and God told him to make the tabernacle according to the things that he saw in heaven. Hallelujah. So here we begin to see the tabernacle that Moses made. It has three parts, and this is a mystery that's been revealed in this end time. We look here. There's the courts, the outside, receiving the light from the S-U-N. Praise God. And we look here. This is the gate. At the gate here on the east was Judah, the lion of the tribe of Judah. When the sun rise, and we see here the gate, and we told you the gate was Jesus Christ. He said, I am the door, I am the truth, I am the way, I am the life. So this gate here is Jesus Christ. In other words, in the body of Christ, you cannot enter there by shaking the pastor's hand. You cannot enter there just by coming to church. You need to meet Jesus Christ personally.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God. Then you can enter. This is a mystery. It's like a human body. It's like a human temple. The Bible said, don't you know your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit?
Amen.
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 What was the purpose of this temple in the wilderness? So that God can come in there in the most holy place in the Shekinah glory.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you see here, there was the brazen altar for sacrifice of the people. They would bring a lamb. And we see this is the type of Jesus Christ because he is the only sacrifice. Hallelujah. He's the only name that's given under the heaven by which you can be saved.
Amen.
So this brazen altar, brass means judgment. The sin is judged. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And you find grace. Hallelujah. Because of the sacrifice. And Jesus is the sacrifice. Then you come here, there's a brazen laver where they would come and wash. That's the type of the word that washes you. Jesus said, now you are clean because of the word that you have heard.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So here the word washes you. When you hear the word, praise God,
Amen.
You begin to be washed. The world begin to go away from you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. It's the water of separation because now here you enter the holy place. Amen. And only the priest could come here. Hallelujah. You have the light from the candlestick, which was the type of the church age. Then you have here the table of the shewbread. Praise God. That's still the type of Jesus Christ, because he's the true manna. I am the bread that come down from heaven. Amen. Praise God. Then you come here. This is the holy place. You have a golden incense. Hallelujah. That's the type of the prayer of the saints. The incense that goes up to God. A sweet smelling. Praise God. Amen. So here, hallelujah, the light here is the light from the candle. Amen. Then there's a veil. Only the high priest could go there. And we know the high priest now is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
He's the one, when he was dying on the cross, the Bible says the veil of the temple was rent in twain from top to bottom. Praise God. Amen. Showing you that no man was able to rent that veil but God himself.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The high priest, Jesus, came with his blood and entered in a most holy place you see here.
Amen.
Hallelujah. This is the throne of mercy where Aaron will come in there. This is the ark. Hallelujah. In the ark was the golden pot of manna. Praise God. Gold is the symbol of deity. Manna is the word. It's Christ. It's the bread. And you have Aaron's staff that came back to life, that buried back to life, showing you when you enter in this place here, in the most holy place, even if you were dead, you're going to rise again.
Amen.
With the power of resurrection.
Amen.
Oh, somebody shout.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Then you have the table of the laws. Still the top of the word. This was the ark. So the Shekinah glory of God would come and meet the high priest between the cherubim. Or the cherubim. Can't even have my English right.
Amen. Amen.
Brother Carlos said, it doesn't matter if you studied. All you need is faith.
Amen.
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 Somebody shout.
Amen.
So you see here, in the most holy place where the throne is, the throne of mercy, where the people receive grace, it was surrounded by cherubim, the angels of God. Now look here, down here. There's another throne, that's you. Amen. You are body, spirit, and soul. And we say the veil over here is just your self-will. If this morning we'll open up to God and say, Lord Jesus, I accept you. Lord Jesus, I open up to the Holy Spirit. He will visit you.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
He will save you. He will adopt you, bring you to maturity. Then in the soul here, Brother Branham say, that's where the throne of God is. And the soul is in your heart. There's a place in your heart that blood does not circulate. That's where your soul is. In that soul over here, either you have faith or doubt. But if you are born again, the word of God comes here and places faith. Oh, praise God. That's where the throne of God is. It's the throne of mercy. Forgive those who offense you. Those who offend you.
Amen.
Praise God. It's the throne of mercy. Hallelujah. But one day it will become a throne of judgment, because the Bible said, don't you know, he shall judge angels.
Amen.
He shall judge the world. Amen.
Amen.
So you see here, it's surrounded by angels. This throne over here, on the outside, you have the four living creatures. Hallelujah. Around that throne. Praise God. And we show you here, also around your temple, your body. Amen. You are surrounded. Your throne is surrounded by the four gospels. Luke, Mark, John, Matthew. These four gospels are guarding the throne of God inside of you here.
Amen.
And the angel of God must be there to guard the throne. So this type must be true today. Look what the prophet says. Hallelujah. Look what the prophet says. Now we are talking about the ministry of angels around the throne. Amen?
Amen.
And we're telling you the throne is in you.
Amen.
It's not in the wilderness anymore.
Amen.
If you go to Israel today, you will not see this tabernacle in the wilderness anymore. It's a shifted. Now it's in you. Paul said it's a mystery. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If this throne was guarded by angels, supernatural beings, then the throne in you must be guarded by angels. If the throne in heaven, where God is surrounded by angels, those angels, when Isaiah saw them, Isaiah chapter 6, hallelujah, it says, when King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord, praise God, and there was seraphim, hallelujah, all around the Lord, and there were they were crying, they were shouting, "Holy, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty." Notice these three times: holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. Amen. Why three times? Why not five times? Three is the number of perfection. Amen.
Amen.
Justification, sanctification, baptism of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
God always works in three. Father above us, Son, hallelujah, among us, Son of Man, Son of God, Holy Spirit in you, Son of David, three. Amen. Holy Spirit, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. How many God? One God. Different dispensation.
Amen.
The same God.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit is the Father. Brother Branham said, if the Holy Spirit is not the Father, then Jesus had two fathers. Hallelujah. Because it was the power of the Holy Spirit that came upon Mary. So the Holy Spirit is the Father. Jesus Christ is also the Father. Jehovah of the Old Testament is Jesus Christ in the New.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah. Watch what the prophet says. Did you ever notice how Solomon built his temple? Amen. He said, listen close. So now this was the tabernacle in the wilderness. But when Solomon came to build a temple, remember David was to build a temple. And Jesus, God told him, you cannot build a temple because your hands are full of blood. You have gone through so many wars. But your son will build a temple for me. And our son was Solomon, which is the type of Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are you following me? Your son David will build a temple for me. Now the son of David, Christ, he's building temple in the believers. Hallelujah. He said, he that is in you is greater than he that is in the world.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Solomon, the son of David. Hallelujah. This is in the natural. Build the first temple now. Hallelujah. Jesus, the Son of David, is building temple in you. A dwelling place, a resting place for God. So get rap music away from you.
Amen.
Get the world out of you.
Amen.
Oh, praise God. Get all the distraction.
Amen.
Clean your house.
Amen.
Praise God. Sanctification is what you do. Begin to cleanse your life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Wash your clothes so that the Holy God can live in you.
Amen.
Can come inside of you.
Amen.
Oh, praise God.
Amen.
Then you become a mystic.
Amen.
No weapon formed against you shall prosper.
Amen.
No witch.
Amen.
Nobody can touch
Amen.
You.
Amen.
Somebody
Amen.
Shout.
Amen.
Brother Gallo. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you go to Texas,
Amen.
Fire in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 If God be for you, who can be against you?
Amen.
I feel like I was 18 again, Brother Bree. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. Look at that temple.
Amen.
When Solomon built that temple, he says this. When he entered in the door, and the door is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The entire Bible speaks about Jesus Christ and you. The entire Bible. Brother Branham said, if you read a verse, you don't find him, read it again. But I'm telling you, it's Christ in you because you were in Christ, just like Eve was hiding in Adam
Amen.
Before the foundation of the world.
Amen.
Praise God. Look at that temple. When you enter the door, what happened? There was angels. Amen.
Amen.
Carved out of olive wood with their wings dipping across that every worshiper coming to the holy seat come right down across the tip of this angel's wing, right down to the mercy seat, right down to the altar. You know the order of Solomon Temple. Well, what is an angel? What is an angel?
Ministering to serve.
Okay. What is an angel? The Greek word for angel is angelo. What does it mean? Messenger.
Amen.
They come, they are ministering spirit. They come bringing messages. God has messengers. Amen.
Amen.
Just like a man who wants to marry a wife, he sends a messenger. Brother Carlos sends a messenger to Texas.
Amen.
Say, go tell Mama Sola, that I'm coming soon.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I'll be there. Amen. It's still a mystery. When are you coming? I'm coming soon. And I'm going to rapture the bride. He sends messenger and God uses angels.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The Bible says, I'm going to read you, they are powerful, supernatural beings.
Amen.
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 God in the throne around you. Don't be afraid of what men can do, because they will do nothing to you.
Amen.
All you need to do
Amen.
Is to be in connection with Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
So this temple of Solomon, which is your type, because your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit, is surrounded with angel. And the prophet asked, what is an angel? A messenger. He said, get the dictionary and find out what an angel means.
Amen.
He says, some of them, the heavenly messengers. Now, we're going to tell you there's two classes of angels. Now, because of sin, amen, we have the fallen angels. Amen. We have the good angels like Gabriel. Amen. Those angels. Then we have the fallen angels that become demons. So today, we're going to start our lesson talking about the good angels. Hallelujah. Then we'll talk about demonology. Amen. Demonology pertains to the fallen spirit, the fallen angels. Amen.
Amen.
So the heavenly messenger, these are angels of God that come to you. How do you know when an angel comes to you that it's an angel from God? How do you know? Turn with me to Psalm 103. Verse 20. Psalm 103. You need to be grounded in the word. We do not worship angels, but we believe in angels. There's a difference. Amen?
Amen.
Praise God. He says, Psalm 103, 20. Bless the Lord, you his angels. So we know the angels, they bless the Lord. If you see an angel come, a supernatural being, because 2 Corinthians 11:14 says that Satan can change and disguise himself into an angel of light.
Amen. Amen.
Satan, the fallen angel, can disguise himself into an angel of light.
Amen.
Him being the angel of darkness, he can appear unto you like into an angel of light. You have to have a clue. Amen.
Amen.
Brothers, because when you're treading into angels' realm, you have to be spiritually rooted, not to be confused, because that's deep spirituality. Amen.
Amen.
People ask for vision. People ask for supernatural. But you need to be taught the word of the living God.
Amen.
Otherwise, you're going to be confused.
Amen.
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 You got to know. Which one is what? Psalm 103 said, bless the Lord, you, his angels. So when you see an angel say, begin to curse the Lord Jesus Christ, you know it's not an angel from God.
Amen.
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 Because the angel bless the Lord. Amen. You who excel in strength. See, they're powerful. They're more powerful than 10 million U.S. Army put together. How many angels destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah?
One.
Two.
Two. Just two. It was super nuclear power, more than the atomic bomb. Just two. They told Lot, get out of here. This place is going to be destroyed. They're telling you today, get out of the world. It's going to be bombed and destroyed.
Amen.
They have nuclear weapons just waiting for what? You think they're playing games? Nuclear weapon waiting to be, hallelujah, sent for war. Amen?
Amen.
These people don't have the Holy Spirit, and you are trusting your future with them. You said, I have time to party. As long as that president does not press the button, but he does not have the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
And you're trusting in him, Amen. You better trust in the Lord.
Amen.
You know, tomorrow is not in your hand.
Amen.
Oh, praise God.
Amen.
I'm talking to you young people. Amen. We have a testimony Wednesday. If you guys don't come to Wednesday prayer meeting, I'm telling you, it's changing.
Amen.
There's another dynamic. Amen. There's a supernatural.
Amen.
We were talking about the book of Acts, how we need to see the book of Acts in the church. Brother Branham saying the true church is the repetition of the book of Acts.
Amen.
Everything else is false. And we were talking about the book of Acts. Then when we begin to pray, I said, Brother Richard, would you pray for the youth in this church? Amen.
Amen.
And Brother Richard began to talk, began to pray first for the youth in the city. Now notice, when the prayer is led by the Holy Spirit, it's wonderful.
Amen.
Brother Richard, would you pray for the youth in this church? Brother Richard began to pray for the youth in the city. In Colorado, he began to pray. Then he prayed for the youth in the church. Amen.
Amen.
As we continue to pray, Sister Sephora prayed again for the youth. As we continue to pray, hallelujah, I just seen Shalom begin to tap me on the back. I know something was happening, but there was a brother, a young man, a youth, Brother Daryl. We don't even know where he came from. We didn't know him. He entered in a church. Amen.
Amen.
God, the angel of God, brought him in the church as we were praying. And he began to weep and cry. He said, you don't know what would have happened to me if you guys were not praying. You don't know. You have no idea what would have happened to me if you guys were not praying.
Amen.
And he began to pray, to sing and to cry. He was full of guilt. But the angel of God brought him here because a church was praying for the youth in the city.
Amen.
There's no accident. That's the supernatural power of God.
Amen.
Amen. That's the ministry of angels. Now watch here what he says. This angel excel in strength. Who, watch it, who do his word. What does the angel do? His word. They obey God's word.
Amen.
Amen. Heeding to the voice of his word.
Yes.
So, return this. The angel obey the voice of God's word. They obey the word of God. That's why Paul said in the book of Galatians 1:6, if I or an angel come down from heaven and preach you another gospel, another word, let him be accursed.
Amen.
Paul said, I repeat it again. If you see an angel come down shining lightning and speaking something that's contrary to the word, don't be afraid of him.
Amen.
Let him be accursed, because it's not an angel from God.
Amen.
So the angel from God, they only repeat God's word.
Amen.
They only obey God's word.
Amen.
So if you speak God's word, the angel will be activated. They will be in action. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To fulfill that word.
Amen.
Amen.
That's why you only need to speak faith.
Amen.
Like Brother Carlos say, and faith is a revelation. Faith cometh by hearing.
Amen.
And hearing the word of Christ.
Amen.
Amen. When faith is in you, you only speak God's word.
Amen.
And the angels of God, when they hear that word that's coming out from your mouth, hallelujah, hallelujah, they begin to act upon that word.
Amen.
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 Oh, praise God.
Amen.
So they are messengers, and they only obey God's word. Amen.
Amen.
Let's continue. While we're preaching on angels, it's very important. They are around the throne. Hallelujah. This is not something that just coming like that. It's in the Bible. When we preach, we need to make sure the things that we're saying, it's in the Bible, it's in a message.
Amen.
Watch here what the prophet is saying. In a spoken word is the original seed, Jeffersonville. He said, that's the reason I believe in divine healing. Amen.
Amen.
That's the reason. How many believe in divine healing?
Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. Because if there's no divine healing, there's no resurrection. If you don't believe in the power of divine healing, how will you be in the resurrection?
Amen.
Because in the resurrection, there are dead bodies. Amen. Jesus will speak the word, and the body will be healed. Come back to life. So divine healing is just showing you a proof that there is a resurrection. This church, we believe in divine healing. We believe these signs shall follow them that believe. In Amen. My name, you shall cast out devil. Amen. You shall lay hand on the sick. Amen. The sick will be healed. Amen. We believe Mark 16. We believe John 14, 12. The works that I do shall you do also. Amen. Greater than this shall you do.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God is a supernatural God. Amen. And he said, that's the reason I believe in visions. How many believe in vision?
Amen.
Bro Branham said he did. Many message believers, they're thinking, since Brother Branham left, there's no more vision. That's a lie from the pit of hell.
Amen.
They believe there's no more divine healing. That's a lie from the pit of hell.
Amen.
I can show you when divine healing started. You show me when it stopped, when God took it away.
Amen.
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 You couldn't find it. The prophet said, I believe in divine healing. That's the reason I believe in angels.
Amen.
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 So Brother Branham believe in angel. He said, that's the reason I believe in this message is because it comes from the word of God.
Amen.
So the angels, it's the word of God.
Amen.
Anything outside the word of God, I don't believe it. Amen.
Amen.
So don't believe anything that's not the word of God. Let me read you another quote. It wasn't so from the beginning. Because people will say, in that church, they're talking about angels. They're going crazy. So we want to tell you that the prophet believed in angels. So it's not something that we are making up. Amen?
Amen.
It wasn't so from the beginning. He says, you take the word of God and explain it all away into some sort of creed. Amen. So you make the word of God like a denomination, a dogma, a creed. And then say, then you cry, where is the God of the Bible?
Amen.
Many people are saying, where's the supernatural? But you have taken and explained the word of God away.
Amen.
You said there's no more supernatural. He said, you've explained him away. You've took it all away from the people.
Amen.
When you tell them that the days of miracle is past. Amen. He said, there is no such thing as the Holy Ghost. There is no such thing as divine healing. There's no such thing as visit of angels. When you say that, you explain the word of God away. How many believe in visit of angels? The time of decision, he says, 2,000 years hasn't changed it a bit. You say it's been 2,000 years ago. It has not changed it a bit. Because the Bible says, heaven and earth will pass away, but my word, says the Lord, will not pass away.
Amen.
Amen. God cannot change. So 2,000 years is nothing. Amen.
Amen.
He does not change the word. Time does not change eternity.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen!
Because God is eternity. How can time change eternity? It cannot alter the word because the word of God is eternal. The Bible says the word of God abides forever.
Amen.
Forever, oh Lord, your word is settled in heaven.
Amen.
Where is heaven? Now it's in you.
Amen.
A portion of heaven is in you because of the Holy Spirit in you. Forever, oh God, thy word is settled in heaven. Let it be settled down in you, in your heart.
Amen.
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 And the same dividend that was paid off at Pentecost, do you know all the blessings were paid off by the blood of Jesus Christ?
Amen.
Amen. It's still being paid off by him. He said, the gift of the Holy Spirit, it was paid off. Amen. So it's for us. It's a gift now. When you go to the store, you buy a gift. You spend your money. But the receiver don't have to buy, does he? Because you make him a gift. You pay, and then you make him a gift. So the Holy Spirit was paid off. The price was paid off. Now it's a gift for us. Amen.
Amen.
He said the power of healing to see visions, angels to appear to you. Hallelujah. That's already all paid off. Amen.
Amen.
Now, since we're talking about angels, don't you want to ask yourself, when were angels created? Now notice we're talking about the angels around the throne. Let me read you one quote and then I'll tell you when the angels were created. For the angels to be around that throne, amen, that throne need to have God in there. The prophet said in the book of Revelation chapter 4, you say a God, oh, I can tell dirty jokes. It does not condemn me. Why? They ain't got nothing in there to condemn it. In other words, the throne is not in there in you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. No. No one's there to take it out. Amen. There's no one there to condemn you. Because it's the Holy Spirit in you that convicts you.
Amen.
Amen. Well, I tell you, the woman say, I can have short hair. When the Bible says in 1 Corinthians 11, women, keep your hair long, and men, don't look like sissy, keep your hair cut. Have an hair cut. Hallelujah. You say, I can do this. The men say, it don't hurt me to smoke cigars. And it don't hurt me to play some cards and shoot some dice. Whatever they do, it don't hurt me. They still belong to the church. See? I can still go to church. Nothing is wrong. The pastor don't scare me. He can preach all he wants. I'm all right. I'm going to make it. It shows there's no control tower in there.
Amen.
You said, don't hurt me to do this. Why? There's nothing there to judge you because that throne in here, it's the throne of mercy and the throne of judgment in yourself. Amen.
Amen.
When somebody hurts you, Father, forgive them. See the throne of mercy. Amen.
Amen.
When you want to go in the nightclub, the judgment, oh, you can't go there. See?
Amen.
That same throne in you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's the control tower. Now, if it is like that, you say, but when Christ comes in you, you've created an altar on your heart and your sins are taken daily. You are justified like you never done it before. Praise God.
Amen.
That's when angels can come around your throne. Amen?
Amen.
Now, who created angels? And when did the angel were created? Let's turn to the book of Colossians 11:30. Still doing good. Amen.
Amen.
Turn to the book of Colossians. You will see who created angels. In the book of Colossians chapter 1. Colossians chapter 1, who created angels? We're going to see as we talk about this. We want to see the ministry of angels. Praise God.
Amen.
What do angels do? Why are they here? The angel that was going up and down the ladder, what was that for? It's a great ministry. It's very important. You say, I have the Holy Spirit. I don't need angels. What about Peter? He was filled with the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And he was in prison.
Amen.
He was taking a nap. And the Bible says, the angel of the Lord came into prison. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Like the government or the police put you in jail. And you have a mighty friend. Your friend is the governor of Colorado. Amen.
Amen.
They put you in jail. You're sitting there. And you see the governor come. Your face lights up. Say, my trouble is over.
Amen.
I have friends.
Amen.
Amen. It's not what you know. It's who you know.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. If you know God and you have fellowship in his kingdom.
Amen.
Peter, He knew Jesus Christ. He was filled with the Holy Spirit. He was sitting in prison. They were going to kill him on the morrow. They put him in chain that no man can break. Hallelujah. Amen. There was no man with the power of Samson right there. So he was there, poor Peter. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the prison.
Praise him in the morning. Praise him in the noontime. Praise him when the sun goes down.
God said, whoa, I love that. Angel, go down there and visit him.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When the angel came, see the human race, we are far away beyond in technology and power.
Amen.
Amen. You need a saw to begin to try to, electrical saw to begin to try to work through the chain. So much noise, they're going to catch you. There's a prisoner trying to break and run. No, you don't need that in the spirit realm. You don't need any tool to work like Adam in the garden. You just speak the word.
Amen.
The angel came and he just touched it. My friend, the chain fell off.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, praise God.
Amen.
John said, when I saw Jesus, I fell on his feet like dead. There's another energy. Hallelujah. That just emanates from his presence. Supernatural energy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Just a touch from an angel of the Lord. The chain. Break. The chain got scared. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Too much energy.
Amen.
There was a heat. Fire.
Amen.
Do you know fire will melt any chain?
Amen.
Praise God. The fire just. Peter said, I'm seeing double. I'm seeing a vision here. Am I on earth? Where am I?
Amen.
So he began to walk. Wow, all the gods are sleeping in Africa. When the fifth come to your house, they have those magic potion. They put it on you, you start snoring. Wow, the fifth comes, they take all of your things, they even take you out and put you laying on the street. Then they leave. In the morning you wake up, man. I'm on the street, yeah. The wife is out wide open. The devil just imitates.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the gods were sleeping and Peter was walking. Don't you like to be friends with Jesus?
Amen.
And his angels?
Amen.
To set you free.
Amen.
The angel of deliverance.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Men were thinking, it's finished for Peter.
Amen.
It's finished for Gabriel. It's finished for Christian. It's finished. I got him. But the angel came and it went outside of the door. Now Peter was filled with the Holy Spirit, but he needed the ministry of angels. Even Jesus himself, after he was tested, Matthew chapter 4, by the devil, the Bible says the angels came to minister unto him. Who are you not to believe in the ministry of angels that are here to comfort you? Oh, praise God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you believe, ye shall see the glory of God.
Amen.
So Colossians 1:16 says, he says this, talking about Jesus, by him, for by him, all things were created.
Amen.
That are in the heaven, that are on the earth, the visible, the invisible, whether thrones or dominion. Do you know dominions and thrones? Dominions and thrones and principalities and powers. All things were created through him.
Amen.
And for him. Who created the angels? Christ.
Amen.
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 Amen. When were the angels created? After man was created?
No.
No. Why did God create angel? Amen. Why did he create you? See, you need to find answers to those questions. Then you will find the meaning to your life.
Amen.
Amen. If you don't know why you're here, then you don't know where you're going.
Amen.
And if you don't know who is God, you don't even know who you are. If you don't know who your father is, you lost your identity. Amen. Amen. It's important. I want to know my roots. Who is my father? Who fathered me into this world? Why am I here? People trying to go, the African American going to Africa to find their roots. Where am I from? Hallelujah. And the Christian, they are not bothering to find who is their father.
Amen.
Who is your father?
Amen.
Your father is rich. He is powerful. This hurting hip is nothing for him.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hey, he opened Adam. Crossed the wound.
Amen.
Supernatural power.
Amen.
Amen. No anesthesia. You don't have a stay in a hospital. It's supernatural.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
When were the angels created and why? Watch this. It's the mystery of God revealed.
Amen.
Why they were created and why you were created. Amen.
Amen.
The prophet says in Christ is the mystery. He says this. 102 paragraph. He said, now God's secret mystery. Now it's not a secret anymore. It's been revealed. Amen.
Amen.
He had before the world began, before the cosmos, before the sun was put there, before the moon was put there, before any molecule, before space and time, God had a secret.
Amen.
Now back in the back part of God's mind. Brother, this is powerful. Brother Branham is even going back to the back part of God's mind. By revelation. Just like Moses. He went in the beginning and said, in the beginning, God, our Elohim, created heaven and earth. Was Moses there?
No.
Yes.
Yes.
Where were you when I laid the foundation of the world? You were in him. When Jesus was dying on the cross, we were in him. We were his spiritual genes.
Amen.
You were there when God was creating.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But Moses was a prophet. A prophet is built up in a special way. He can go back in time. He can go ahead of time.
Amen.
And tell you the things that was and the things to come.
Amen.
Amen. And if he be a prophet from God, it has to be exactly the word. Now, the prophet of this end time is telling you about the bad part of God's mind. Whoa! He said there was something that he was trying and was going to achieve. God is an achiever. You, his son, you are also an achiever.
Amen.
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 You are not a failure.
Amen.
And he had a motive in doing it in order to let himself be expressed. So all of this, God was trying to express himself. Amen? Because first, there was not even a moon, a star, atom, molecule, or anything. But he was God. But he exactly wasn't God at that time because God is an object of worship. And there was nothing to worship him. So he was Elohim, the one who exists by himself. He was not manifest as God yet, because there was no one to worship him.
Amen.
There was no space, nothing. How can you explain that? How God stood, no space, nothing. Can you comprehend that? That's too much for our finite brain.
Amen.
It's even hard to calculate some equation, let alone to figure out God.
Amen.
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 They just give you an equation in physics. Your brain begins to explode. Now you say, I can explain God? Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
The one, the greatest of the scientists. My.
Amen.
So why here? So in his great mind, he wanted this attribute to be expressed. So he was God. But there was nothing to worship him. And in him was love. In him was to be the Father. and he wants to be the son, and he wants to be the savior, and he wants to be the healer, and all these great attributes that we see already expressed were in God. So, my opinion, the first thing that he made was angels. And then they worshiped him. And that made him God. So the angel began to worship him. Holy, holy, holy. Then that made him God. Amen. Before he created anything else, he created the angels. All the angels. Lucifer. All of them. He created. And they were worshiping him. And he was God. Watch this. Starting from there. As in previous messages, I've tried to explain it. Break it down. Now, when the angel began to worship him, that was before there was even a molecule in the earth. The earth was not created yet. Amen.
Amen.
The angels were created. They began to worship him. Where were you?
In
him. Amen.
Amen.
In his spiritual genes. Hallelujah. Praise God. There was nothing. It was all darkness. The angels were created. It was all darkness. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. There wasn't the sun, no moon, no star, no nothing. Then it was God. As he asked Job, where were you when I laid the foundation of the world? See, when the morning star sang together, the sons of God shouted for joy. Now see, where were you? That was back there before the earth. That's when the angels were created. What for? So that they can worship God and he can manifest his attribute that he is God. Amen.
Amen.
And he created all the angels. Amen. But God knew there will be fallen angels. Hallelujah. But the other angel will not fall. They will not disobey him.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. Do you see?
Amen.
Amen. We cannot finish this lesson here. We need to continue. Hallelujah. In this lesson,